This is the moment Roman Savin knew he was saved. He set sail on the Swanland as one of a crew of eight, but then he was just one of two survivors. We spoke to them shortly after the sinking. Then they described being washed into the sea. Today the inquest heard more about what happened to them.
Neither of the survivors gave evidence in person. The jury heard from statements they'd made shortly after the sinking. In his, Roman Savin told how the ship was hit by a massive wave which buckled the hull. He sounded the alarm, seven short blasts followed by one long one. His captain sent out a Mayday alert. Roman Savin went on to say how the ship was hit by a second big wave. The next thing he could remember, he was in the sea, suing for the surface.
This is the Swanland before the sinking. She'd been built in Holland in 1977. Her last voyage had begun at Raines Jetty near Colwyn Bay. There, the cargo of limestone had been concentrated towards the middle of the ship.
Marine accident experts suggested the Swanland had sailed into a perfect storm. It had been sunk by a combination of factors: its age, the way its cargo had been loaded, but also the size of the waves it was battling its way through.
The Swanland sank in minutes. In evidence, an RAF winchman described seeing debris floating in the sea. Despite extensive searches by air and on the sea, only one body was ever recovered. The inquest is due to resume in the morning.